get things started on
the most sensational, inspirational, celebrational, muppetational. This is what we call a Muppet Show!
Thank you. Hi, hiya, hiya. Hey, hey, hey. Listen, Kermit is letting me help plan tonight's show.
Oh, that's true, folks. He plans his parts and I plan the good parts.
Kermit!
Oh, I'm just kidding, Fozzie. Go ahead, make your introduction.
Oh, okay. Moving right along, we take you now for a trip into inner space.
I am very relaxed. I'm terribly calm and tranquil. I'm very, very relaxed indeed. On the outside, but on the inside, I'm like a circle in a spiral, like a wheel within a wheel, a never ending, a beginning on an ever-spinning reel, just like a snowball down a mountain, or a carnival balloon, or like a carousel that's turning, running rings around the moon, cause like a clock whose hands are sweeping past the minutes of its face, see that the world is like an apple whirling silently in space, just like the circles that you find there in the windmills of your mind, just like a tunnel that you follow through a tunnel of its own, way down a hollow to a cavern where the sun is never shown, just like a door that keeps revolving in a half-forgotten dream, or like the ripples from a pebble someone tosses in a stream, cause like a clock whose hands are sweeping past the minutes of its face, see that the world is like an apple burning silently in space, just like the circles that you find there in the windmills of your mind. Keep it tingle in your pocket, or to tingle in your head. Why did summer go so quickly? Was it something that you said? See lovers walk along the shore and leave their footprints in the sand, or is the sound of distant drumming just the fingers of your hands? Song. Half remembered names and faces, but to whom do they belong? Cause when you knew that it was over, you were suddenly aware then that the autumn leaves are turning to the color of her hair, just like a circle in a spiral, like a wheel within a wheel, never ending or beginning on an ever spinning wheel. This is the damages of wine, just like a circle that you find, you're in a windmill of your mind. On the outside, I'm very calm.
Well, how'd you like that opening number?
Oh, I didn't notice it.
Didn't notice it? How's that possible? It was loud and raucous with a screaming thing running amok. Well, how could you not notice it?
Well, in the future, I'll try to be more observant.
Could you do that, please?
Wire for Kermit the Frog. Wire for Kermit the Frog. Are you Kermit the Frog?
Of course I am.
Wire for you.
Cute. Cute bit.
I love a good running gag.
Once again, by popular demand, Mr. Fozzie Bear.
Yeah, love you all. Yeah, it's me again, the old Fozzie Bear. Hickory dickory dock, a laugh a minute by the clock.
Oh, yeah? Well, you better check your clock. It looks like it stopped.
With a lovely girl. She's so bow-legged, when she stands around the house, she stands around the house.
Hey, you remind me of Charlton Heston.
Charlton Heston doesn't tell jokes.
Well?
Look, I'm good enough to play the palace.
You're not good enough to clean the palace.
Didn't you like my last joke?
Yes, if you promise it's your last joke.
You guys wouldn't know a good joke if you fell over one.
Well, we're not in any danger with your act.
Okay, Muppet Labs on stage next. Muppet Labs.
Well, Mr. Kermit, where's Beaker?
Beaker, I'm sure I don't know.
Fiddle faddle. I shall have to cancel Muppet Labs this week.
What?
And I was going to give Beaker the honor of demonstrating this new diesel shaver.
It's a close shave for Beaker either way.
Sorry to cancel at such short notice.
Oh, that's okay.
Hate to go out there and lose face.
I'm sure Beaker felt the same way.
Hey, this is a new one. I'll plug it in and see if it's working. It's working!
Okay, owing to the unfortunate cancellation of Muppet Labs, combined with the fact that the furniture is taking over the show.
We've also got manamana, whatever that means.
Manamana. Manamana. Manamana.
Just a second. It's for you.
Manamana.
The question is, what is a manamana?
The question is, who cares?
Letter for Kermit the Frog. Letter for Kermit the Frog. Letter for Oh, are you Kermit the Frog?
You know I am, Fuzzy.
Letter for you. letter, funny.
Someday I'm gonna get him. I don't know how, but I'm going to get him.
And now, Veterinarian's Hospital, the continuing story of a quack who's gone to the dogs.
Well, let's take a look at our next patient. What seems to be his problem?
I think he has flat feet, Dr. Bob.
Looks more like a flat tire to me.
I think it's a case of three left feet.
Three feet, Dr. Bob. What do you make of that?
Oh, about a yard.
But is it serious, Dr. Bob?
Let's face it, this bird has 1 foot in the grave.
But he has 3 feet on the table.
Well, that's nothing. I left 2 feet in Cincinnati.
That's 6 feet, Dr. Bob. What do you make of that?
Oh, about a fathom.
I certainly can't fathom any of this.
And so Dr. Bob has performed another amazing medical feat. Tune in next week when we'll hear Nurse Piggy say...
Shall we call in a specialist, Dr. Bob?
No, we'll just call a tow truck.
Notes for Kermit the Frog. Notes for Kermit the Frog. Oh, are you Kermit the Frog?
Yes, Fozzie, I am Kermit the Frog.
Notes for you. G sharp.
Will you guys cut that out?
Funny. Funny. I like it.
Thank you.
Oh, what'd they miss?
Oh, nothing. They just bombed again.
Oh, watch this. Have I got a topper for my running gag tonight? Oh, it is too much. Okay, watch. Flour for Kermit the Frog. Flour for Kermit the Frog. Oh, are you Kermit the Frog?
You know I am, Fozzie.
Flour for you. See, that's a joke. Yeah, and that was the punch.
No, Fozzie, this is the punch.
Stand the horn the book, waiting the flapping jack and hooking. And stand the horn, yes, you heard about the booking. He's going to board there. Misty board there, horn, spear, horn, there, just flip. There. There's fork to hear, the flip, flopping the jack and the pecking with back and black and hooking too. There's fork, dear, horn, dear, steer, dear, more scared, whip. And spare corn, they're stooping on the hooping. Friends, Corey, they're murdering, they're just really hoard. They're steering the hook and digging the spear. And they flip chucking the voo goop. They're in the fork up there, they've heard. They get the blue in the boost in there, they're pouring the bear, they've heard.
I know what's wrong with this show.
What?
It's the theater.
What's wrong with it?
The seats face the stage.
Here's a Muppet News Flash. Today is the opening day of the fishing season.
Say music hath charm to soothe the savage beast.
Such is not the case here, however.
Get him.
And now, it's in space!
When we last left the rocket ship Swine Trek, it was drifting aimlessly in space due to a power failure in the control panel.
Oh, first fight, Piggy. If Dr. Strangeport can't restore power to the control panel, we'll be marooned in space forever.
Oh, no!
Well, look at the bright side, my dear. At least you'll spend the rest of your days with me.
That's the bright side?
Well, I fixed the control panel.
Oh, that's wonderful, Doctor.
Yeah, it was faulty filing.
Nice work, Dr. Strangeport.
Oh, it was nothing, Link. Actually, I just used some vials from the electric toaster.
Good thinking. Here, I'll try it.
Uh-oh.
That's all right, Doctor. Actually, it's kind of funny.
Yeah.
You see, that's what you call raising a pig.
Raising a pig. She has her ups and downs.
So you think that's funny, huh? Well, it's your turn, Linko.
Thought you had me, didn't you? Why don't you try this one right here?
I am not that stupid.
Oh, then I'll try it.
He was that stupid.
I want my mommy.
Still think it's funny, bacon brain?
No, we've got to get Dr. Strangeport back.
Hey, I'm not supposed to be here, right?
Right. What happened?
Bigger!
I don't believe that.
I'm not supposed to be here either, right?
Muppet News Flash. This is the opening night of the opera season, and...
Silence. A poem by Rolf. That's me. Silence. Hear the nothingness. Listen to the quietness of everlasting space. Down the winding velvet corridors of time, it sweeps. And sweeps. And sweeps. And sweeps away the sound of creatures crying in the night. Creatures crying in the night. And cry we must, for we have tasted the forbidden fruit. But lo, lo, the faceless name. The... Faceless names, the nameless faces whisper of our woes. But overall, the blessed silence falls, sweet serpentines of silence singing their sad song. Out of the silence and dark, we build the music. Silent music. And the endless emptiness of emptiness drumming in our ears. Will you all get out of here? But in the end, all is silence, quiet, silent ways, all still.
Hi, could you hold it down, Ralph? We're trying to do a show here.
A masterful performance.
Reminiscent of the late Rudolf Besser.
Rudolf Besser is dead?
No, he's late. He was supposed to be here at...
Statler, You always get me with that same dumb joke.
Well, maybe it's not the joke that's dumb, if you catch my drift.
Now, Bear, on patrol.
All right, come on. You just come with me, you. Sir, Sergeant, I have just picked
up... In a minute, Patrol Bear. I have to finish this report. Oh, Dredd, I made a mistake. Now I'll have to start all over again.
But, sir, can't that report wait?
No, this is a very serious charge.
What is it?
Littering.
Sir, this also is a very serious charge.
Oh, yeah? What's the charge?
Impersonating an officer.
Can you prove it?
Of course I can prove it, Sergeant. Go ahead. Do your stuff.
Okay, impersonating an officer.
Of course I can prove it, Sergeant. Go ahead, do your stuff.
Hey, that's not bad.
Thank you.
Yep, now look, Sergeant, this is a very dangerous criminal. He should be locked up.
I think he should be locked up. Here are the keys. I'll finish up the report.
I'm going to lock him up.
Well, I should have known better than to try to fool with you, Patrol Bear.
Yeah, you're darn tootin'.
After you.
Thank you. Listen, tell me what kind of food you like. See you later, Sarge. Sergeant! Wait a minute, he locked me in.
Not bad, you sound more like him all the time. Now try to do me.
Sergeant, you don't understand, he got away.
No, that's not me. You still sound like a dumb bear that brought you in here. Try it again. I have a deep, authoritative voice.
Sergeant, will you just turn around, please?
better, but keep trying. You need more macho.
What'd you think of that?
I liked it.
Oh, you, you like that?
No, I just wanted to see what you do if I said I did.
I started on a journey just about a year ago to a little town called Morrow in the state of Ohio. I've never been much of a traveler, and I really didn't know that Morrow was the hardest place I'd ever try to go. So I went down to the station for my ticket and applied for tips regarding Morrow, not expecting to be guide. Said I, my friend, I'd like to go tomorrow and return no later than tomorrow, for I haven't time to burn. Said he to me,
now let me see if I have heard you right. You'd like to go tomorrow and return tomorrow night. You should have gone tomorrow, yesterday, and back today, for the train that goes tomorrow is a mile upon its way. If you had gone tomorrow, yesterday, now don't you see, you could have gone tomorrow and returned today at three. For the train today, tomorrow, if the schedule is right, today it gets tomorrow and returns tomorrow night.
Said I, I'd like to go tomorrow, so can I go today and get tomorrow by tonight if there is no delay?
Well, well, I said to him, and I've got no more to say. Can you get anywhere tomorrow and get back again today?
Said I guess you know it all, but kindly let me say, how can I get tomorrow if I leave this town today?
Said he, you cannot go tomorrow anymore today, for the train that goes tomorrow is a mile upon its way.
I was so disappointed, I was bad enough to swear. The train had gone tomorrow and it left me standing there. The man was right in telling me,
you are a howling jay, you cannot go tomorrow.
Well, I guess in town I'll stay.
I don't get it.
Well, that's about all the time we have.
This show brought a tear to my eye.
Really?
Yeah, I'm sitting on a tack.